What's up, guys? Got a battle with my buddy Crunk Skunk here, and he's just like me with this whole battling thing. He originally started playing Call of Duty and kind of branched off into Wi-Fi battling because it's a fun thing to do. And he's going to be using an OU team. I'm going to be using my MixedTier team with some BLs and NUs, or not NUs, UUs thrown in there too. Anyway, I'm going to lead with my Frostlass. He leads with his Swampert. And this Frostlass is awesome because everyone expects it to be a what's it called? Focus Sash lead. And so I start off with the trick, and I trick Swampert my Choice Scarf, and already that Swampert's pretty much, crippled. He switches to Infernape, and I spikes, predicting that switch, and then I go out into Tentacruel to take the close combat because Tentacruel is just an epic Infernape counter unless Infernape's packing Earthquake. Can Infernape learn Earthquake? I assume it can, but anyway. Yeah, he's gonna have to switch out because close combat drops his defenses and he doesn't want to get one hit KO'd, and he goes into this stupid thing. I hate Blissey. I really do hate Blissey, but I rapid spin away the stealth rock he put up, and that's good because I have a lot of ice types on this team that take some damage from stealth rock. But anyway, I'm gonna set up toxic spikes here, and he should have predicted that, but instead he predicts a switch, or he didn't know that poison types could get couldn't get poisoned or something like that, and he goes for the toxic. So that's gonna allow me to set up two layers of toxic spikes, which is just awesome. And he goes into Swampert again and gets regular poison because he came in before I put up both layers. But that Swampert's poisoned and Choice Scarfed, so he's not gonna be too much of a threat. I switch out and go into Melodic, fearing the Earthquake, but he actually goes Stone Edge there, trying to predict the switch into a flying type, which was a good play on his part, actually. And this Melodic, even though it's a UU, it's just a flat out, defensive and special wall. And I go for a Blizzard here, just because Surf would be too obvious for something, and it pays off nicely because he goes into this stupid Breloom, and I hate Breloom too, just as much as Blissey. And it takes it out in one hit, and that's awesome for me. And you might be asking me why I have Blizzard on this thing, since Blizzard only has 70% accuracy, but you'll see in just a bit why I have that. He goes out in the Kingdra though, and then he switches to Infernape, predicting something, I'm not really sure. And I just withdraw my Melodic and go into my Abomasnow, and this is why I have Blizzard on that Melodic. Blizzard in the Hail is 100% accurate, and this is actually a Hailstall team, but he didn't know that until now. And honestly, that's why I like this team so much, is because they don't really know what it is until about halfway through the battle, until I reveal it. But anyway, I go out into Tentacruel to block the close combat again, and it works out great for me. And he's forced to switch again, I think, predicting the Surf. And I think he goes into Kingdra. There's a lot of after turn effects now, so my narration might get delayed with all the stalling. But no, he goes out into Swampert. Takes some spike damage, takes some surf damage, and then he's going to take some hail damage and some poison damage, and that's awesome. And he doesn't have a rapid spinner on this team, so those spikes, that one layer of spikes, and those toxic spikes are going to do a number on him. And I'm going to withdraw here and go back into Melodic to take whatever he does, because Melodic, like I said, is just a defensive and special wall, and especially when it has a status condition. Its defense gets boosted by 50% with that Marvel scalability, and you'll see that come in handy later. But anyway, I take down his, what do you call it, the Swampert, and he goes back into Blissey, and I can do nothing to Blissey, and it sucks because Blissey has natural cure, so these toxic spikes aren't going to hurt it too bad if it just switches out. And I Blizzard him, just predicting a switch into something, but he just stays in, goes for the Wish, and I'm not sure if he's going to try to heal his Infernape or just go into something completely different, but I'm just going to Surf this turn, I do believe, in case it is Infernape and he tries to heal that. But he goes into a Scissor, and I'm not really afraid of the Scissor because, I mean, even if it's Choice Banded, my Melodic and my Tentacruel can wall this thing pretty good, and if that's not enough, I got a Gliscor, which will really wall this thing because it's especially defensively bulky. And we're gonna take some damage from the hill here, but since I have leftovers, I'm not actually taking damage, I'm just not healing. So anyway, I go for a Surf again, and that's gonna do a pretty good amount, about one-third damage. And he's just going to U-turn. And after seeing how much this did, I know now that he's choice banded. So I know that you know, he's not really that much of a threat as long as my walls stay alive. And he goes in the Blissey here. And I don't think Blissey has Thunderbolt, or else I would have seen it by now. So I'm pretty safe just to go for the rest here. And this is actually a Sleep Talking Melodic. And the reason it's a Sleep Talking Melodic and it has rest is because when Melodic, like I said, has a status condition, its Marvel skill ability, it boosts its defense up like by 50%. So this thing will actually counter Scissor more when it's asleep. So anyway, I'm just going to Sleep Talk this turn in case he decides to switch out. And I go for, I think I get the Surf actually, which is pretty good for me. And even though Blissey's a special wall, he's going to take, you know, decent damage from it. And combined with that Toxic Poison, it's going to really rack up. And if he comes back in again, he's got to contend with the Spike Layer again, like I said. And the Hail. So the residual damage is really racking up for him, even on his walls like Blissey. So that's good. And he's going to switch here and go to something. No, I switch, I think. Cause I predict his Protect. And I switch out into Gliscor. And if this thing has Ice Beam, I want to know what special attack this thing has. Because if it has Flamethrower, then I don't want to send out any of my Ice types like a Bomb of Snow. And I just want to scout here. So I'm going to go for the, what's it called, the Roost. Because it removes my Flying type temporarily. And if he has Ice Beam, it probably won't kill me. Because this is a max HP Gliscor. I've got no EVs and special defense, but still, Blissey's special attack isn't that great, so he probably has no EVs invested in it either, but he just switches out, which tells me he doesn't have Ice Beam, and goes out into Kingdra, and I'm fearing the Waterfall, so I'm gonna, I can't remember what I do here, I think I switch out into Tentacruel to take the Waterfall, but he makes a good play and just Dragon Dances on my switch, and that's gonna get him to plus one attack and speed. And if I were him, I would have just tried to keep Dragon Dancing, because that's his really his best bet to win this battle, is just to keep Dragon Dancing with Kingdra, because my Tentacruel can't really do much. Its only effective attack is like HP Electric, and that's really not going to do a lot at all. Anyway, he goes for the Outrage, though, and since that's such a powerful attack, and with plus one attack, it's going to take me out. And so down goes one of my Scissor counters, but I still have Melodic, so I'm not worried that much. And since he's locked into Outrage, I know I can go into Gliscor now to take that Outrage very nicely, because I have, like, this is like a bold, I think a bold or something like that, Gliscor. So it's got, like, max defense, max HP, so it's going to take that nicely. And I think his Kingdra is going to die this turn to the poison. Yes, it does. So that's good for me. And down goes his Kingdra. And that's really his last that was his last chance to win this battle and come back. And that's gone. So that's great for me. He goes out into Infernape. I'm going to switch out predicting the whatever, close combat. I'll go into this thing because look how well it takes that close combat. That is crazy. That's not even resisted. And because of Melodic's awesome ability, it takes that extremely well. And I think here he's going to actually go for the Fire Blast. And I was surprised to see how much this actually did. But compared to you know, my physical defense, since I'm asleep, it's not too surprising, even though it's resisted. But anyway, his Infernape goes down to the Life Orb damage. I Sleep Talk and get a rest, which is pretty funny. And I'm sitting at pretty low HP here. So he goes into his Scissor, probably just to kill me. I know that Gliscor can take whatever it does pretty handily. He goes for a U-turn, and that's not going to do much at all, especially since it's resisted. He goes back into Blissey, gets poisoned again, and I'm just going to roost with Gliscor because now I know he doesn't have the Ice Beam, and I know it's safe to do because he will die to the poison and the hail next turn, so whatever attack he has, it might be Thunderbolt, in which case he can't really do anything. So, but I do Roost, and that is going to be awesome. He goes for the Flamethrower, and that's not going to do anything really. But I'm glad I know he has the Flamethrower now, because I was tempted to send in a Bomb of Snow earlier. And wow, does the poison not kill it? Wait, I think it kills it this turn. Yeah, there we go. Okay. I was about to say. Anyway, he goes out into his last guy, which is Scizor, and he can do nothing to me pretty much since I'm a defensive wall, so he goes for the bullet punch, doesn't kill me. I finish him off with an earthquake, and that's a good game. So that was a fun match, Crunk Skunk. Don't feel bad that you lost, because I plan on putting every match I have on Pokemon, win or lose, up. And just remember that you learn in defeat. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it. Please rate the video if you did enjoy it. Please comment the video if you enjoyed it. Tell me what you thought. See ya.